Georgian Social Democrats were not, I would argue, though I'm sure I will get a lot of pushback on this from Georgian scholars, were not Orthodox Marxists. By 1918, the Georgian Social Democrats were arguing even further that small nations, just the large nations that the world was talking about, but small, tiny nations, also had the right to the rights. Chairman of the Georgian government for almost its entire existence, also continued to be the Georgian Democratic government in exile until his death in 1953, but the Georgian Republic was they felt they were creating a system that was different from other republics in Europe at the time. Because what they wanted to do was combine popular power through the referendum, through local government, through the election of judges. The Republic did introduce the vote for women, when in the UK there was no vote for women at this time, or in the United States. They also introduced separation of church and state, a multi-party legislature. The idea was that this government would not be separate from the people, because once it turned over to the government, they accepted the state as a manager of